This is video 26 in the lectures on the design of reinforced concrete beams. This lecture demonstrates with an example how to calculate a crack width. We have a section with a depth of 600 and a width of 300 millimeters, a concrete cover of 30 and a stirrup diameter of 10. The section is loaded with a bending moment of 25 kilonewton meters under the mobile loads and 55 kilonewton meters on the permanent loads. The loads are given in SLSQ. Concrete quality is C3037 and the creep coefficient is 1.8. We want now to calculate the crack width when the reinforcement, the tension reinforcement, is 4 diameter 16, and in a second case we will calculate the crack width with a reinforcement of 1 diameter 32. 1 diameter 32 is 800 square millimeters, 4 diameter 16 is also 800 square millimeters. So the total area of reinforcements is the same, but we will see now what will be the difference in the crack, in the calculated crack width. We start in SLSQ. Crack width calculation is always done in SLSQ. The total bending moment is the 25 plus 55 is 80 kilonewton meter. So this means that 25 and 55 were not characteristic values, but were values in SLSQ. If this was a characteristic value, then we should have multiplied 25 by the psi factor, which is 0.3 for buildings. So we assume this, that the bending moments are given in SLSQ, not in a characteristic value. We calculate the K factor, which is the effect of the permanent loads divided by the effect of the total loads. We calculate the modulus of elasticity. The creep coefficient is given. This is just the formula for the modulus of elasticity of concrete. And we find something around 15,000 megapascal. Alpha, which is ES divided by EC, is 13.6. Okay, we expect in SLSQ something like 15. So this is in the right order. Reinforcement was 800 square millimeters. The depth or the center of gravity is the concrete cover, the stirrup diameter, and the point of gravity of the bar, of the rebar, it makes 48 millimeters. So the effective depth is the total depth minus 48 is 552 millimeters. We calculate the depth of the neutral axis for the cracked section, and it gives us 168 millimeters. Now we will first check if this section is cracked, because if the section is not cracked, it has no sense to calculate the crack width. So we will first try to see what is the cracking bending moment in this section. Pure elastic design and the distance to the most tensioned fiber is H minus X. The mean tensile stress in the concrete is 2.9 megapascal. The depth of the neutral axis for the uncracked section is 340 millimeters. So you see, we just now calculated the depth of neutral axis for the cracked section, which is half of this one. So don't make any mistake in here. It's 340 millimeters. The moment of inertia for the uncracked section, this is just using the formula for the equivalent section. It's 6 times 10 to the power 9 millimeters to the power 4. And so the cracking moment is then easily calculated, and it's 61 kilonewton meter. This is smaller than the loads, than the bending moment applied to the section. So it means that the section is cracked, so we can calculate crack widths. The maximum crack spacing is given by this experimental formula. The effective reinforcement, we start with that with calculating AC effective. This is the width times the minimum of those three values. H we have, X we have. X is the cracked section. It's the X of the cracked section. All those are known, all those data. So the minimum is then 120 times 300 is 36,000. So AC effective is 36,000 square millimeters. And the effective reinforcement ratio is then 0.022. The center to center of the reinforcement, we have four diameters, 16, so the center to center is 68 millimeters. And if the center to center is smaller than 5 times the concrete cover plus half the diameter, it means smaller than 190. If this is not the case, then SR max is 1.3 H minus X. So 86 is smaller than 190, so we use the regular formula for SR max and we arrive at 224 millimeters. The delta epsilon times the modulus of elasticity equals this formula and must be bigger than 0.6 sigma s, so we need to calculate sigma s, which is here. And because it's an elastic design, it's easy to calculate sigma s. And we have 200 megapascal as a steel stress. We calculate the delta epsilon. Everything is known now. And we find that delta epsilon is 0.662 10 to the power minus 3. Then finally, the crack width is the delta epsilon times SR max, and it gives us 0.15 millimeters. So the section with a load of 80 kilonewton meter will have a characteristic crack width of 0.15 millimeters. Now we will do exactly the same exercise with only one diameter 32. Now, of course, in reality, a beam has at least two rebars instead of one, but this is just for the purpose of comparison, the exact area of 800 square millimeters to compare it with the calculated crack width. So now we take one diameter 32, the K value that stays the same, there's no difference in that, in the calculation of alpha, it does not interfere. We calculate the point of gravity of the reinforcement, that changed. The effective depth is now less. And the depth of the neutral axis of the cracked section is now 166 millimeters. So the influence is not that big. For the 4 diameter 16, it was 168 millimeters. So this is now 166, so small difference. We calculate the cracking bending moment. We follow the same procedure. And we see now that the cracking bending moment is also 61 kilonewton meter. The X changed a little bit and the D changed a little bit and they compensated by accident. So it's 61 kilonewton meter for the cracking bending moment. So the section is still cracked. The maximum crack spacing, the rho effective is calculated in the same way as the previous exercise. And you see that the rho effective changed now. The rho effective is smaller than the previous one. Center to center of reinforcement is now meaningless because we only have one rebar, but we know that the spacing should be, the distance between center to center should be smaller than 230 millimeters. But the section itself, if you look at the width of the section, you will see that we comply with that. If you take into account the stirrups, the diameters of the stirrups, then you see that we still comply on this rule. But in sense, it has no meaning. So we can use SR max, the normal formula, and we have 386 millimeters. You see that this is almost 1.5 times the 224 that we got with the 4 diameter 16. So the maximum crack spacing is increasing significantly. Then we calculate again the delta epsilon, but first to do that we need the sigma s. Sigma s is now 204 megapascal instead of 200, so that's also not that big difference. And the delta epsilon is 0.639 10 to the powers minus 3. Now we can calculate the crack width, it's a multiplication of the two, and it gives us 0.25 millimeters. So you see now that the crack width as or the choice of the diameter of the tension reinforcement has a big influence on the total crack width. You know now that you have to use small diameters with small spacings to control the crack width. See you at next lecture.